As you can tell from that intro, I'm a massive Star Wars fan. As a kid, I adored it. As an adult, I've been inspired by it. It's probably one of the reasons why I do study media and want to break into the film industry. It's just had a massive impact on my life. And alongside that, the reason I've chosen to do my documentary on the Builders Club is because, as of today, Rogue One's top of the box office. Force Awakens broke all the box office records you can think of. Star Wars merchandise is everywhere you go. It's currently sitting atop a peak mountain of hype. It's going to sit there for probably 2-3 years. And then finally it's going to get overdone. So I believe the best chance of submitting a Star Wars documentary is now and over the coming years to distribute it. That will be the best chance for this to go to places. And one of the reasons I picked the R2 Builders Club is because they essentially are a group of Star Wars fans. I'm a Star Wars fan myself and I will be targeting this at Star Wars fans mainly. This will be done via social medias such as Facebook, Twitter. I'll be publishing it on YouTube because YouTube does get more views, especially to a specific core audience of Star Wars fans. For example, there's a short film last year called Maul, which has over 11 million views, and it came out in April. So that does show that there is a core Star Wars fan base, because no one outside that Star Wars fan base did see that film called Maul, and that's something I've taken into account when distributing my film. In terms of content of the film, I have secured a minimum of 5 interviews at the minute. 2 of the interviewees are actually the creators of BB-8. They did begin in the R2 Builders Club, and they've been sort of scouted by Lucasfilm and now work on the Star Wars films, creating the droids, which is a remarkable sort of story in itself, beginning as fans and ending up working on the franchise. I've also contacted several other builders who are interested in doing interviews with me, one of which is midway through a build, so I'll be able to see the production process. And amongst several others, I will be finishing filming at MCM Birmingham Comic Con in March time. I've got confirmation and a press pass for this to be able to do filming, which is fantastic. It means I won't be any issues when I'm doing film, and just have to make sure I have consent in case any other people are interested in doing interviews for it. And I think the reason I've chosen that is because it'll be interesting to see the sort of droids in action finish and how the public react to them. And that's something that is one of the questions I want to answer. And the sort of the contents, I want to know why these people choose to build their own R2. I want to know how they do it. I know they start from scratch, but are there blueprints, what's involved? How do they help each other, and how do they get the parts? There's so many questions that can be answered, and I think this will be quite interesting. It's certainly unique. This is something that hasn't been done before. This isn't the average sort of electronics course. These are people that are building it from scratch, from circuit boards, and each droid varies from the other. It isn't just R2-D2 they design. They've done BB-8 from The Force Awakens, Chopper from Star Wars Rebels, and even little things like the mouse droid from A New Hope, which 99% of people won't recognise, but it's something that's been done, which is a testament to the Star Wars fan base, because they do have this reputation of being incredibly over the top. And by these people designing droids that have been in the film for 10 seconds, I think that's something really cool that can be explored. In terms of distribution, this will be shown at film festivals, traditional ones, such as Sheffield Documentary, BFI Feature Filmmakers, and I'll be looking at a more modern approach, especially targeting the fans, so I'll be taking this to conventions, going along with the Builders Club to try and market the film to other people, and I believe that'll be one of the most effective ways for this to take off. In the meantime, I do have some test footage I shot. This is not with someone from the Builders Club, this is with just a way for me to test how the interviews will go, how I'll be merging the interview with the interactions with the droids themselves, so this won't be in the final cut.
Hi, my name's Dan. I joined the R2 Builders Club just after the first trailer for The Force Awakens was released onto the internet. I thought I'd try and be the first person, or one of the first people, to build a BB-8 model. To begin with, I built a small-scale replica because the technology was new and it was a lot of improvisation to see what worked, what didn't work. But now it's the small scale replica's finished. I'm planning on building the large life size one, which will be the exact same as BB-8.